Hi, I'm Mina. Say What? I'm here at Radio 103.9 in New York for Cumulus Urban, and I present to you at home and everyone here, James Davis. Yeah, can I get a little hand clap or something? Woo! Okay.
Thank y'all.
You light my fire, got me so damn hot, I'm burning up. My one desire, a secret love. I get a fever every time you leave me. Temperature 103. Oh, you got me sweating through the sheets. Chills running through my body. I hate when it's so good. Tears of joy make me feel sad. You got me tossing, turning in my sleep. Now I keep singing in my dreams. You light my fire.
You light my fire.
I'm so damn hot. I'm burning up.
I'm burning up.
My one desire. I'm sick of your love. I'm sick of it. You light my fire.
You light my fire.
I'm so damn hot. I'm burning. You was coming right back.
Right back.
How you leave me on the couch like that?
Like
when you kiss me on my lips, I don't move. And if you're playing games, I'm sure to lose. I wanna get better, but I can't tell you now.
But I can't tell.
It's looking like I took an error. 'Cause I keep coming back for more. You like my light. You like my fire. So damn hot, I'm burning up.
I'm burning up.
My one desire, I'm sick of your love. I'm sick of it. You light my fire.
You light my fire.
So damn hot, I'm burning up.
I'm burning up.
My one desire, I'm sick of your love.
The way you make me feel.
Maybe I'm going crazy. Have it like a knife. Passion's never burning up.
Maybe I'm going mad.
Maybe I'm going crazy.
I hit it now, gotta have it.
Gotta have it like a knife.
Passion flame, you ignite.
Passion's never burning up.
I'ma tell my wife I ain't coming home tonight.
You light my fire. Got me so damn hot. I'm burning up.
I'm burning up.
My one desire. You light my fire.
You light my fire.
So damn hot, I'm burning up.
I'm burning up.
My one desire. Sick of your love.
Thank you.
Thank you. So this next one is called Something to Talk About that we just released a couple of weeks ago. Let's get into it. Y'all good?
Okay.
Talk about. We got something, let's work it out. We got something to talk about.
We got something, oh yeah.
We got something, let's work it out. You've been working, I've been working, so we should relate. Gets lost, schedules crisscross. Both got heavy plates. You've been feeling how I'm feeling. Ain't where we wanna be, but I don't wanna lose this grip. They don't come easily. This good,
what I say?
Don't come easily. Yeah, we got something to talk about.
We got it. to talk about.
We got something, let's work it out. Conversations work with patience. Baby, let's find the key to every door open some more. And tell me how you want us to be.
Tell me how you want us to
be. See us later in our home with kids eventually. But we can't give up just cause we're stuck. If you wanna live happily,
wanna live happily, yeah.
Happy.
What I say?
Living happily, yeah. We got something to talk about.
Yeah, we got it. Yeah, we got it.
We got something, let's work it out.
Yeah, we got it. Yeah, we got it. Something
we
to talk
it.
About.
We got something. Let's work it out.
Work it out, yeah.
It's working out.
Oh yeah, 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 it's working out.
I was searching, then I found you.
Oh yeah, it's working out.
Oh yeah, it's perfect now.
Oh yeah, it's working out.
Oh, you got my attention now.
Oh yeah, it's working out.
I just hope you hold it down, down, down.
We got something to talk about.
Talk about, we got shit to talk about.
We got something, let's work it out.
Yeah, we got it. Yeah, we got it.
We got something to talk about.
We got
something to talk about.
We got something, let's work it out.
Give
thank
it up.
You. Yeah, yeah, thank you.
For James Davis featuring Zach the guitarist.
Thank you.
You guys are so good. Mm. We got something to talk about. Wonderful. We got a couple of things to talk about. It's where you going, honor. Austin? You trying to leave the interview?
No.
Austin's like, I did my part.
No.
I'm out. So Jess, Ray, and Austin,
yes,
a.k.a. James Davis,
yes.
One word.
Yes.
Thank you guys for coming and sharing your gift with us.
Thank you for,
having us. Real shit.
So you guys are actually all siblings.
Yes.
That's amazing.
It's
I don't think
twin.
I've ever met. So I know we were going to get to that. I don't think I've ever met like a three, you know, sibling group. It's normally like two or.
Yeah.
Or the cousin.
Right. Cousin, like the Migos, right. You know, mm-hmm. their cousins and stuff like that. But mm-hmm. you guys are fraternal twins.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So you were in the womb together, but then came out separate, right?
Eight minutes first.
So you're the oldest.
Yeah. You see, she said 8 minutes twice. Like it really, like it's such a thing.
Wait, so is she the more dominant one?
I think we take turns. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Between all three of us?
No, really. Like, it depends on the situation.
He's somebody father someday.
Word. Mm-hmm.
Someday, not now?
No.
Some days, he's somebody father.
Oh, you want to be your father?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay.
I don't have no kids. Not like that. We're not trying. We're not looking for no kids. She just said,
you
I,
sure
look, I look, nah, I'm very positive.
No.
I just look after them sometimes.
Are
like
you married?
My kids. No, hell no. Nah, hell
okay, because
nah. Don't say hell no. Damn.
But I've been in definitely like situations where I
you're
feel like
almost married?
No, I just mean like, but when you like
oh, you playing married.
When you live with somebody, like I've been
you
in situations where we live together, so that shit felt like a marriage. You
right,
know what I mean?
Right. Because
yeah.
he had a lyric that said, I'm not going home to my wife. What was
you know
it
what
that
saying?
You said?
Yeah, going home to my wife. It felt like I was in a marriage, like, you know?
I can't.
It wasn't married.
The first
but shit.
Song, right?
Yeah.
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 I'm not
yeah.
going
you
home
like
to
my
wife.
Yeah.
I'm like, wait a minute.
Yeah. That's my favorite part of the song, right?
Right.
Laughing at the end.
I started to think, do you have a wife? Like, why would you write that in there?
It's going to be a long time before I live together with a woman. You know what I'm saying? That was probably the last time for a very long time. Yeah.
Wow. You were like, I'm good on this.
Wow.
Yeah. What do you guys believe? Do you believe you should live with someone first and then get married or get married and then live with them?
I think it's the best way.
I think it's the smartest thing to live with someone and really see what's what.
Right.
Yeah, that's a different thing. Sharing a space, that's right. different, man.
Yeah,
that's
exactly. Different. So how old are you guys?
So we're 30.
Mm-hmm.
26.
Yep. You're the baby. Mm-hmm.
Not necessarily baby, but
yeah.
So it's only you three, or are there any more kids to your family?
On our father's side.
Yeah. We have
but
siblings.
But we all three have the same mother, same father.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Us three.
And then we have an older brother, older sister.
So where does the musical talent come from?
Both parents.
Really? What do they do?
20.
Okay, 20 is okay.
Excuse me. Our dad, obviously, professionally, he was a ball player, but he grew up in the church, and then my mom was a background singer, so we got it honest.
Yeah.
Oh, so you guys got, like, the church upbringing. Yeah. Did y'all sing in church?
We did not.
We did not, which is interesting. But
really?
I think we tried to.
They
one
never
time.
Got to go out there and sing a hymn.
No, they tried. It's just like the rehearsals and everything. We moved around a lot. Schools, our schools would usually be far from home, so like we never had like the time to actually.
So you guys grew up in California.
Mm-hmm.
Where's your family originally from, though?
Houston.
Yeah, Houston, Texas. On my mom's side, Sacramento.
Okay, how'd you guys end up in California?
Well, our mom was actually raised in the jungles.
Yeah,
if
jungles.
People familiar with L.A., you know what the jungles
is. The jungles of L.A.?
Yeah.
That's the nickname for it, but it's over there. It's like near Dorsey, where Coliseum is.
Yeah. It was called
Where Training Day.
You said the jungles. I'm like,
have you seen the movie Training Day?
Literally.
Have you seen the movie Training Day?
I have.
Okay, so that's where the jungle, over there.
I see.
But I was born in Inglewood. We were raised in L.A. We've literally moved maybe 15 times just growing up in L.A.
Yeah.
Never seen.
And how long have you been singing, like? You grew up?
Us together, five years.
Okay.
Yeah. We always created music. Like, we wrote, produced together. Like, that was really the intent when we first got together. And then it just made sense moving forward that we were a band.
To perform our own music.
Yeah.
Right. You guys write all your music?
We have
the
a
most
team,
part.
Hardcover, and it stays in-house. We all write and produce together.
So, like a production?
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah.
Y'all got a production team, too?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, you better get the money. Right. Wait a minute. Right. Have you gotten placements yet on anything? Like movies?
Yeah,
Love Me
TV
was
shows.
On, what's our show?
Oh, Queen Sugar.
Can't Love Me.
It was a scene, like I was late watching the show, but everybody called me, was like, oh my God, like this was a pivotal moment between, I guess, the guy and the girl. They were broken up, the main characters. What's the dude's name?
I don't
Kofi
know, but it's
something.
Kofi. I know,
yeah, it was Kofi and like his baby mama or something. They're in a bar, and then you hear this slow acoustic song come up. That was one of our records and stuff.
So, are you seeing the residual money from that? Like, is there good money in that?
I heard it is.
We'll
like, I see my BMI statements. Like, you see it, but
okay,
but it's
girl,
like,
you better.
Oh no, I look at everything.
My BMI statements.
I want some movie placements.
Movies are next. Like, we have some stuff coming up with this project, and we're gonna get on some other projects that I just got wind of. Like, a couple
okay,
days
so
ago.
By this project, you mean Masterpiece?
Masterpiece, yes.
Okay,
on Friday.
So tell me about that.
So
it's an EP or is it an album?
It's an EP.
EP.
Okay. Yeah.
It's seven songs though.
But it is an EP. It's Masterpiece, a play on the word piece, P-E-A-C-E. Austin, you want to elaborate on that?
It's just we've been working towards just mastering peace. Just, you know, growing up, it's been so much around us. Just a lot of different changes, a lot of shifts.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes just a lot of drama. Just, you know, growing up in LA, of course, you know. But you know, we're just working on mastering peace.
How do you do that? Can you do that?
You can.
It takes a lot of effort.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. You fuck up sometimes, but I mean, for the most part, I feel like this year has been probably one of the most peaceful years compared to the other
ones. Agreed. Mm-hmm. I think all three of us at the same time made a conscious effort to kind of adjust, I think. And I think that's why I think together we were centered.
Wow.
We're getting there. Yeah, anyway.
Were you guys fighting before that?
No,
not
us.
Just, no, see, the thing is, like, we're always good. We're very...
yeah, like, even when we do fight, we're good.
Yeah.
But like, I would say our relationship is so much better now.
Yeah.
Now that you're working together?
Yes.
Really?
I
would think it would create more issues.
Mm-mm. No, I think it's something to have, like, a common goal, which is we want to be able to live... this is our, not just a job, but like we're doing music together, we have goals, we want to travel. I think to have a common goal, you're just like unified automatically. And then as siblings, and even us getting older, we're learning how to communicate better with each other because we are in business together.
Right.
You know, because we are siblings, we're very honest, you know, we don't sugarcoat anything, but also we're business partners as well, so like it teaches us how to communicate better with each other, I think.
So you're always the lead singer?
No.
Right?
Those are just the two songs. That,
okay.
Like, we have records where it's predominantly Austin or Jess. I'm not even on some of the records. Like,
right.
It literally just depends on the song. There's
and what's
no...
funny is a lot of the times the argument will come in because we don't want to sing the leads. We're literally trying to push the lead.
Yeah, like,
really?
There's not, I want to sing lead. No, it's literally the song.
It's
like,
what fits best for the song.
What fits best for the song.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, I think we play on all three of our strengths and we know what... or what we would like the song to sound like, and then that's how it comes about.
Austin, do you rap or you just sing? He does everything. Let me hear some bars though. Some people don't be ready for that.
Yeah, nah. But like you'll hear a record called Black Leather Bag on the project, which shows a different side. I think, like I said, like we're not tied to a genre or a style. It's just whatever fits the record, honestly.
It's funny you say that because when I was researching you, it said that you were a band.
Yeah.
So you guys play instruments?
Yeah, I play guitar. I didn't play today, but we play. That was a setup originally. I was switching between acoustic and electric. Austin was running
beat machine and a keyboard.
Like the machine and the controller. So
do you make beats,
us.
Austin?
Yeah. We all produce. Yeah.
Like our first EP was mainly just us.
Yeah.
Like nobody really helped us on the production
side. Wow.
Yeah.
Like how old were you then?
I must have been maybe like 21.
I was like 25 then.
Yeah.
Wow, that's amazing. 25.
We recorded in his bedroom. Like, literally, our first project was recorded in Inglewood in this apartment called Lamplighter on Hazel.
On Hazel. Mm-hmm. On the brand Hazel. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Wow.
Yep.
So, you guys are signed to Motown. How did that happen? Mm-hmm.
It's crazy.
Harold introduced us to
Harold
EP.
Who's Harold?
So Harold Lilly.
Oh, okay.
I'm like, who's Harold?
I know.
You know who the Kelly 47 is?
Yes, yes.
So he is who signed all of us, James Davis and the Kelly 47.
Aren't you on tour?
Yes,
with
Kelly.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, so that's how that collaboration happened.
Yeah. Facts.
Okay.
But so he introduced us to Ethiopia. She came to our house in her Jordans. Mind you, mind you, we had like 3 beds in the living room because the bedroom was the studio. And I did not want her walking up in our place like that. Like I was ashamed
draws
at the
everywhere,
time.
Girl.
Yeah, no.
It just looked like real tight.
It was a real tight setup, you know,
but it was
the
beautiful
neighborhood too.
Yeah, the way she came and was just proud of us and listening to our music, and we in the room really, really getting emotional over music, just music.
Yeah.
And she signed us with Steve Barnett. The two got together and signed us. We didn't have a following. We didn't have any music out. Nothing.
That's
she
rare.
Was that in love
with
the music.
Right. No, it was very rare. It was
very rare.
Yeah.
100%. Yeah, because now you have to have all these Twitter followers and Instagram followers and a
following.
I don't
think we had an Instagram. We had to make an Instagram, I remember.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That's a blessing.
Yeah.
So how do you guys make decisions? Is there like one person that's kind of the more...
We vote two.
If two says yes,
oh, that makes it so easy. If it would have been 4 of y'all would have been asked like, damn, we split down the middle.
Yeah, it just makes sense. But usually, I mean, mostly we're in agreement, but it just helps make decisions quicker.
Mm-hmm.
So who's like the responsible one?
Ray.
I can kind of pick up on that. Who's the smartest one?
All of us.
Yeah.
No, be honest.
No, real talk.
All 3 of us are very intelligent. I would say that.
Yeah.
But like book smart, I would say Ray.
Okay. Yeah. Who's spoiled?
Me. I'm just saying. Austin.
Austin spoiled?
Like I can't
with
even.
Love,
I,
with love.
Yeah,
with love.
I can barely get mad at him. I don't know why. Like, Ray can do the same thing, and I don't know.
I'm your twin. Like, I don't get a pass because it's like I'm you. Mm-hmm.
So who's the evil twin? Is there an evil twin?
I'm evil? Never in life. Stop it. No, I'm super cool. I'm super cool.
Y'all gonna fight about that later on. Like, damn, you had to
like, just put me out there like that. Nah.
What does your mom think about your career?
I mean, she's the reason why we're here.
Mm.
Facts. Yeah, she is our... She's our light, honestly. Like, that woman...
Oh, that's sweet.
She literally sat us down. We were working on so much music, but, like, not finishing anything because we were doing other things. I was working and whatnot. And she sat us down and was like, listen, I need you guys to actually finish something. I need to be able to play something. If you're not able to do this in a certain amount of time, then you guys aren't taking this seriously. So y'all got 10 days. And that's how we got our first project.
Mm-hmm. Yes, mom.
Yeah. Mama.
Can we clap it up for mama?
Yes, we can. Yes,
mama made a whole group happen.
Yeah,
Mama Davis.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah,
that's amazing.
We actually didn't know we were gonna be a group.
No,
she just wanted songs completed.
Like, as far
we
as
only wanted to produce and songwrite. That was our goal. We just wanted to.
So we wanted to, you know, we wanted to be a part of different projects and really be just like. I love discovering music through TV and film, right? Mm-hmm. And so the goal was, let's do that. Let's write music for television and film and places. So that was originally the goal. And then
that's why you have the production company.
Yeah, exactly.
Right.
And then the conversation began, okay, so who's gonna sing this? Like, there's three voices that are very different.
Very different.
And
she's so strong and you're so soft. Mm-hmm. And
yeah, and the Austin's between the two of us. Like,
he can literally do both.
Yeah. Right. Like, there's parts in records where people think it's me, like, because it's like falsetto. I'm like, no, that's actually Austin, but all good.
Will you sing a falsetto?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Can I hear that?
I like
at least?
Creative music, whatever sounds best.
Wait, can I hear that at least? Is that a lot to ask?
Why
for?
You have to tell her I'm singing falsetto?
I want to hear it.
We're going to think about it. Finish the interview. We're going to think about it.
Yeah, get your vocals together, and at the end, you can hit me with a little dream.
Yeah. I can't.
So what were you guys doing? Because you started around like your 20s. So did you have like a real job? What was your real job before this?
I had a couple jobs. I originally started in wardrobe. Like, I started doing wardrobe for film, actually. And then I started running a natural company called Roots Nutrition in Inglewood. It was like my first job originally at 15, but I was like managing the entire store and was doing that for a long time. Yeah, and then I literally was still working there after we got signed just because I had to find my replacement, so I didn't want to just leave. But
Austin was at, what was the school?
You were at Los Angeles
Simply
Film
School. Wholesome.
Oh, you were where?
At Simply Wholesome on Slauson and Overhill.
Oh, wow.
And they fired me. And they fired me. And so after that, I was like, I promise I will never work in a regular 9-to-5
Wait, why did they fire you?
I still don't know to this day.
No, yeah, I really don't know.
I literally
know
went up to the job, and I was looking for my time card, so I asked the assistant manager. I'm like, what happened? Like, I don't see my time card. She's like, I wasn't told anything, you know what I'm saying? But I couldn't go to work because my time card was missing. And so maybe, like, I left, and I sent the head manager a text, like, I don't see my time card. She never replied. I took her, like, maybe 2 weeks to tell me, like, oh, yeah, I'm sorry, it didn't work out.
What?
So after that, I was like, yeah, never again.
But he was in school, too. Yeah. He was going to Los
Angeles. I was going to school.
Damn, this is not the worst. That's like showing up to work and your key card don't work.
What you mean? Like, I've never heard of it. Never heard of such
crazy.
A thing. Yeah.
How about you?
So I actually was privileged enough to get checks that sustained me because I did a lot of acting when I was a kid.
Oh, wow.
So I was...
Where?
You're not going to say it? You're not
were you
play?
Into commercials? What were Wait a minute. What kind of acting?
I did a
like
little
porn?
Acting.
Like porn? Hell no.
I was like, hell no.
The way you said it.
No, the setup
was really weird.
She was in
Moesha. When I was a kid.
You in Moesha?
She was in the Bernie Mac show.
Girl, you better tell them.
Have you seen the movie Holiday Heart?
God. Yeah.
She was the little girl in Holiday Heart, Alfie Woodard's daughter.
Yep.
Wow.
Bing Rains.
Yeah. Yep. Okay. She did a lot of things growing up. But
so you were on the Bernie Mac show? How was that? I used to watch that show every week, girl.
Moesha was funny.
The show was great. Honestly, even meeting Bernie.
Yeah.
Like, that was amazing.
What's he like in real life? God rest his soul.
Like the show?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love that show so much growing up.
Me too.
And Moesha.
Yeah, Moesha too.
What's funny is Bow Wow played her brother because you guys were the siblings of Ray J's character, I think, in the show. It was like a 2-episode arc. It was like a whole thing.
Why are you embarrassed about that?
I'm not embarrassed.
She always wanted to sing.
You just didn't want to say anything. That's amazing.
Yeah.
And I feel like you're shy right now that we're even talking about it.
Yeah.
She's like, yeah.
You should be proud of that. That's great. Any acting in the future?
I would like to write scripts. And then if the character suits something I could do, then yeah, I'll hop in it.
Yeah.
Any training? Like, did you get actual training in acting?
What's funny is I did not, and they just liked that, I guess, about me. Because I understood personality, you know, and I would just jump into them.
You got the movie on like, just some random stuff. Our mother, the beautiful queen.
The light.
You know what I'm saying? The reason why we're, you feel me, not all the way insane, you know what I'm saying? But she was trying to... She always just tried to better our lives, so she was actually put me in like a private school when I was in the 6th grade.
Uh-huh.
She couldn't afford it, you know what I'm saying?
But
you feel me? But it happened. So for the few first months I was there, she was able to pay it or whatever. We ended up meeting some great people. She met Alfie Woodard, and she just met my family and just fell in love. It was like, I want your girls to try out for this movie I'm doing, and they did it, and they loved Jessica. You know what I'm saying? And then the rest is history.
And it's so funny because I was so in awe at his school. It was so beautiful. So I was just walking around talking to everybody, and this woman just was staring at me the whole like 2 hours. And so then she walks up to me, all graceful like a goddess.
Yeah.
And she's like, "Let me meet your mom." I'm like, okay. And I take her to my mom.
What I do now?
Right. And so she invites us to a screening down in the Delta. And so that's the name, right? Mm-hmm. So we go to see the movie. I see it and I go, oh, I like her. I want to play her daughter. I just said it like that. And then I went home. I prayed about it. And then a month later, she calls and she goes, listen, I want you guys to get your feet wet with acting. I think you guys should just come audition. Listen, they pretty much already know who they want to cast, but just come and audition.
Right.
I get there, and I, long story short, I go through maybe, no lie, 20 different auditions. All the girl actors, the kid actresses that I used to watch were there. I'm like, ain't no way in hell I'm getting this. I ain't getting this. And I'm just watching them. And yeah, after like the 20th audition,
they
like,
chose you.
They chose me.
Who else was there that I would know or we would know?
Everybody, but I feel like it's like a... I don't want to say now because it's like,
I want to know. You don't be wanting to say nothing, girl. I'm going to talk to your brother and sister.
Who was I actually don't remember who was there. No, like, real talk. Like, it was a lot of familiar.
I couldn't drink your water. Give me your water, girl. You're not going to flake with
I couldn't
water.
Say by name, but I guess faces. If I saw the face, then maybe.
No.
Yeah.
All right. You don't have to divulge.
Yeah.
You're humble. We like it.
She said we like it.
So I feel like you guys really like film. Like, where do you, what kind of, like, I guess, what shows are out now that you want to get placed on? Like, what kind of movies or what kind of series? Is it Narcos or is it like, you know, being Mary Jane or is that, that's over? Or is it like, you know, Issa Rae show, Insecure? Like, what kind of shows do you want to be
like
on?
Like, Insecure would be dope. Grey's Anatomy for me, just because it's like nostalgic. Like, yeah. I discovered so many bands from that television show.
Really?
Yeah, like, oh my God, like Tegan and Sarah, love them.
Okay.
There's this band actually called Sleeping at Last, and a lot of people don't know, they're a band, but they do a lot of covers, but then they also have original music. Mm. And, like, they did, what was the song? I'm telling myself now, but Twilight.
That song is incredible.
The wedding song for that movie, but they do a lot of Grey's Anatomy stuff. So just, I mean, honestly, whatever show fits the song really will be dope.
Whoever cuts the check.
But not even that. Just like if our song could help tell the narrative or just like heighten the scene, I think that's dope. Music does that. You know what
show I do want our songs to get on? Insecure.
No, yeah. What you mean? That's the show.
Yo, everybody be having their music on Insecure. Yeah. Like up and coming, like Tierra Whack had her music on.
Yeah.
I think Malibu Mitch.
Mm-hmm.
Like all these up and coming. Well, they're established enough to be placed,
for
but they're not like everybody knows who they are.
And what I love about it, like, you know, I watch Insecure, but the songs are fitting. Like, you know, sometimes you'll hear a scene, you'll be like, was that really supposed to, did that really go? Like I think
that
that's
didn't really
dope.
Sync up.
Yeah, the way they, whoever's curating.
How about like Love and Hip Hop?
Why not?
Why not?
Like,
the song is
if,
fitting.
Like, literally, if there's a scene,
fitting,
you got girls popping off.
Do you guys have songs that would fit a Love and Hip Hop? I feel like
we have so many records.
Yes,
even
no,
if
we
they're
do.
Not out, but we have all type of records.
Like if somebody's going through a breakup, they can play I Will.
Okay.
They can play.
Look here.
What's the name of the song?
Which one?
Masterpiece. This is what I tell me, bitches. Hang on, no.
Climax. Like, we have that's the thing. Yeah. We have so many records outside of our projects that we would send in for different projects. You know what I mean? So,
shame, though. I used to watch Love and Hip Hop religiously when it first started.
So, you guys are on tour right now. Mm-hmm. What have you guys learned about each other that you didn't know prior to going on tour?
I guess I could say this. I am watching my brother and my sister interact with the audience in a way I've never seen before. And I'm literally up there like, who are these people? Like, it's amazing. And now I have so much more fun performing.
Who are you?
No, I fan of both. Like, we'll talk.
Did we share the same womb? Like,
no, I think, here's the thing. It's a different beast. Like, being in the studio, we're in the studio nonstop. You're not around a lot of people. You know what I'm saying? So being on stage from being in the studio is two different things. Performing your songs live is different. And I think mainly for me, I'll speak for myself, I had to get comfortable. Now, mind you, when we started, the goal was to be in a studio. It wasn't to be on stage. That's a different thing. And,
and
so, we had to get comfortable and continuing to be in front of real people, see their reaction. And the love has been dope, honestly. Like, we've been in front of people that genuinely love music, which is dope. And, they don't even know who we are yet, and they're literally trying to sing along, which is...
What's so dope, though, is we come out, and everybody's watching to see, like, okay, what type of energy you about to give me, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And then they decide that they fucking with us. Ooh, that's the best feeling.
Yeah,
the rest of the show, they just want to sing every song with
us. For sure, yeah.
That's dope.
How about you, Austin? What'd you learn about your sisters?
Honestly,
any awkward stories?
Awkward stories? No awkward stories. I mean, I really think they're great. Like, these are my best big sisters. Best big sisters I could ever have, honestly.
You didn't learn anything from them being on tour? I mean, that's pretty intimate. You're, like, together all day, every day.
Yeah, but it's crazy because even though I'm the younger brother, most people, or I guess most older sisters, don't have their younger brother.
Oh yeah, we're always together. We have the same friends.
But like literally, when I was growing up, I was around them because like their friends or her boyfriend or just whatever. Like you feel me? We just kicked it, even without my sister. Like we just, I don't know. So
I don't think he's ever hung out with anybody his own age. We've always been together. It wasn't like a younger brother or older sister dynamic.
You know what I'm saying? So it's a lot of things I expect from them. I expect great things from them. Yeah.
Aww. Yeah. So you guys, your debut album is self-titled?
You mean our first project or this project?
Oh, that was EP?
Okay, yeah, James Davis. It was self-titled.
Oh, you released it already?
No, so
it's coming up, I thought.
Nah, so the first one was James Davis. The second one was Lamplighter. Now the one that's coming out May 10th is Masterpiece.
Okay, so there's not something else coming out after that?
No.
I mean, we don't have the name for it.
Oh, okay.
For sure.
So Masterpiece is what it is.
Yes, yeah. Friday.
All right, so you guys make sure you check it out. Masterpiece. I could talk to you guys forever because I think
I know, I really got mad comfortable and just realized that we're
like... We're talking with other people. I've just never been, you know, I've never interviewed like three, you know, siblings that are part of a group. Mm-hmm. So I think that's pretty cool. I mean, and you guys are of color. Like, why don't you think we have more bands that are of color?
That's a good question. You know, it's interesting. They're out there because I go see. I think it's just about exposure. I think so. Yeah, because like I go see live shows and they're out there. You know what I'm saying? I think it's just people don't know yet. They're gonna find out. That's
why. Why don't you think they've reached like a mainstream mass level? Like when I think about a band and a musician, you know, I kind of think of like Lenny Kravitz and those kind of people. Like there's not a lot of people that play instruments that are actually consider themselves like.
Because I think honestly, a lot of people. I hope this doesn't come off wrong, but they usually don't care if you play or not. It's like you have to care because a lot of the times, like we had to say, no, we're not a group. We don't do dance move, which is fine. You know what I mean? We're actually a band because we play. I think it's about telling your story and controlling your narrative. And we emphasize on band because we do play instruments and we have other musicians with us. So I think it's just really about the narrative and how, you know, you represent yourself.
I love that. Mm-hmm. Well, before we go, Austin, am I going to get my falsetto? What are we doing here? In a falsetto.
Do the falsetto. Lay down when I get working out. Just do the falsetto. Oh, yes, working out.
It's working out. Oh, yes, working out.
You better work that, Austin. Thank you, James Davis.
Thank you so much.
Don't mess it up. Thank you guys at home for watching. And
appreciate
thank you,
y'all.
Everyone here. Can I get a round of applause?
Yeah. Appreciate y'all.
Once again, thank you. I'm Mina SayWhat. We're here live in New York, Radio 103.9, broadcasting for Cumulus Urban. Thanks for watching. Woo!